Welcome back to the last video of Lesson 3, Level 2. Let's start out this video by showing you how to deal with a lot of stock data, like how we ended our last video. Having so much data, it's hard to tell how the stock is actually doing over time. One way of dealing with this is to add a linear trendline. A trendline tells you the overall trend of the data over a large volume of data, or, as in this case, over a long time. Excel has made this powerful mathematical calculation very easy to add to an existing chart. Just select your chart, and then go up to the Design ribbon. Now select Add Chart Element, and select Trendline, and then Linear. It'll ask you which of the chart data columns you want to add the trend on, and for most stock charts, you'll almost always select the closing price. Just looking at the line, you can see that this is trending upward over the year, and that's a good thing if this is your company. If you're a stat nerd, you want to find out the slope of this line by clicking on it and selecting Format Trendline. This exposes a powerful mathematical menu with some pretty cool choices. See down here that you can display the equation for the line that gives you the slope? That stuff is out of our scope for this course, but it can be pretty useful information if you want to know how much a change in our x-axis affects the value of the data in the y-axis. Please note that this trendline stuff works for almost all kinds of charts, not just stock charts. Another type of trendline is called a moving average. If we go back into that trendline and format it again, I'll now change this trendline type from a linear one to a moving average, and for the moment, I'll leave it at a 2-day moving average. This doesn't reveal much, even if I zoom in to 400%, which is about as much as my machine will allow me to do. Since a 2-day average basically calculates the average between 2 days and plots a dot there, it's really the same thing as kind of drawing a line between all the days of the closing prices. Not very informative. A more useful financial indicator of how a stock is doing might be to see how it is doing against its current 30-day average. Let me adjust the value from 2 up to 30, and let's look and see what happens to our chart. Let me zoom out a bit. Now, as I adjust this period upward, you'll see the moving average take a shape that's a bit smoother. Notice that our moving average doesn't even start until the 30th day. That's because it now requires 30 days of data before it can even calculate that 30-day average. This is useful information for stock traders to know how a stock is performing against that 30-day moving average. So here in the end, assuming that it's today, then our stock is selling a bit below its average. Do we buy or sell based on that? You'll have to answer that one on your own after you take a finance class. I'm not allowed to give you that recommendation. That's all we're going to cover in Lesson 3, so we'll pick you up again in Lesson 4. See you there!